Welcome back to Chow Time Pod. It's your host, Rick.
The videos today from Cheek Slang Headquarters. Generation is just getting out of control. Please like and subscribe down below. I really appreciate that. Let's get that chow. It's chow time.
Я подождите, я пошутил.
Excuse me, ladies. Excuse me, I think your friend is beautiful. She was looking at me. I just want to know, what's your name?
My name is Barbara.
Barbara?
Yeah.
Andrew. Andrew.
Wait, how old are you though?
Me? I'm old enough. How old are you?
I'm 18.
You're 18? I'm 19.
Okay then. That
is okay fine. Then. What are you doing out in Fort Lauderdale? You're too pretty to be clubbing.
I was just in there, but then I left.
So you got a boyfriend?
I don't have a boyfriend.
All right, one last question. Where'd you get that from?
Get what?
That smile.
It worked. You're not funny.
You literally laugh.
You're dead ass not funny.
But you laugh.
Not really. Can you take your glasses off?
No.
Why?
What the fuck? Yeah. Hey, she got me. What the fuck? She just tapped my shoulder because I like them on.
Oh, really?
I think I look better with them. They help me see.
They help you see.
I got bad vision.
I mean, that's what glasses are for, yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So what's up? Like, I'm going to get your number right now.
You can get my Snap.
I don't do
or
Snapchat.
My Instagram.
I don't do Instagram. I don't do Snapchat.
You're getting my number?
How else am I going to contact you?
I mean, I guess. You're cute, so it's fine. Where do you go? What college do you go to?
I don't go to college. I dropped out.
What do you do then?
Me? I do like Forex.
Wait, you're like in the road. What'd you say?
I work at McDonald's.
At least you have a job.
Bro wasted no time explaining Forex and skipped straight to McDonald's.
Cheek slayer.
Tell me why I get so mad when an ugly man approaches me or tries to hit on me.
There's a couple of possibilities here. The first one being, and honestly the most often overlooked one is that a lot of guys that aren't considered to be as traditionally attractive as others are used to getting rejected by women. So therefore, they quite often will shoot their shot with a woman that they find attractive. Why? Because at worst, they're just going to get rejected like they usually do, but at best, at least they can say that they shot their shot, and maybe there's a possibility that she'll be interested, but they're never going to know unless they try. But then there's the other reason.
Like, the audacity, like, stay in your lane! Stay in your lane!
And that reason is one that a lot of individuals might have problems facing up to.
You know, men can easily say the exact same thing to bigger girls and girls that, you know, try to get in relationships with us. Maybe stay in your lane.
Is that that individual might actually be on one's equal attractiveness level, and one just had an entirely overinflated sense of how good one looks the
True.
Entire time.
Get those damn tarantulas off your eyelids! Ladies, before you call a man ugly, just remember, he doesn't wear any makeup. She's talking a whole lot of crap for someone whose whole identity that can be shattered by a single baby wipe.
I want to see what you look like under the mask. Like, why are you hiding your face?
You're gonna show her what's underneath.
I'm hiding my face for the same reason you're wearing makeup.
Thank God you look like your picture.
You know, I can fix her. I'm a dentist and a professional pet groomer.
As a man, I can take accountability and acknowledge that I'm imperfect. So for example, if a chick said to me like, hey Marquette, you know, I really like guys with hair. Then I'll have to say, you know what, if I were you, I'd prefer a guy with hair too. You're giving me some nice waves like mine, like for sure. Like that is better than being bald. You see, I'm not gonna pretend and say, oh, like, you know, like, but you know, male pattern.
True.
I'm not gonna try to explain it away. I'm gonna say you're right. And in that area, I am not top of the category. Whereas if you deal with a woman, you say, hey, rate each other. I'm like, oh girl, you're a bad bee, you're beautiful, you're all tens. Whereas men, we have to live in reality. We have to acknowledge the reality about ourselves and the reality about others and figure out where we stand on the hierarchy.
Men, we live in the cold, hard reality. But women, they live in a freaking Disney rerun.
Has a guy ever cried in front of you?
Yes.
Was it a turnoff?
I feel like it made us closer, actually.
A lot of guys don't know what crying is.
People who immediately respond to your text are not desperate. People who immediately respond to your call are not desperate. people.
It's just people that are on their phones. I'm on my phone all the time. I reply to messages pretty quickly. Other than Instagram and Facebook and stuff, I don't have those notifications on. But if it's a straight text to me, I read those like pretty quickly.
Who are always there for you when you need them are not always free or jobless. Maybe they understand how it feels to be ignored. Yeah. Maybe they know what it feels like to be left alone. Because maybe they were left alone when they needed someone.
First of all, you smell good, which is surprising.
Why is that surprising?
I don't know. I just wouldn't think of you, a guy who would have a nice scent on. And it
that's such a, like, I'm going to really work hard to not take that as a shot.
Who's your hero?
Who's my hero? All right. That's a great question. Well, I think my dad is my hero because he's someone that I look up to every day.
What is your biggest fear?
Having my man out there with his, like, full of...
Mm-hmm. Out where? Just in the world?
Yeah, just in the world. Like, I always have to make sure that, like, I drain him before he, like, leaves. Like, always. He needs really? To be drained, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So why are you scared of him having his full of...
Because I don't want him to, like, get, like, and then, like, some other...
She's not wrong. Know? Like, I need... That post-nut clarity thing. Once we nut enough... Yeah, we have no desire to want to, like, pursue too much. So, yeah, if it lasts for, say, 12 hours, 24 hours, and she just repeats the process every single time, every 12 to 24 hours, she figured out the code.
I need, like, him to be, like, drained. I need to, like, take care of him, you know?
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. So you're just thinking about what he needs.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Such wonderful goals she has set for herself. She's so intelligent. You can clearly tell she was raised by wonderful parents.
When you really? Were only 15 years old, you had a nude video leaked and spread across the internet.
It's unfortunately a memory I'll never be able to shake. It's remained so vividly to the point where, like, I still, to this day, if I get a call in the middle of the night, I'm 15 again and I'm in my room and I'm finding out that this video is out there. And it's really scary. As a young girl, there was a boy that I liked from back home. And when I was sort of already, like, in LA a bit, going back and forth, I started sending videos of myself to him, as I think a lot of people do. And I also won't, like, ever convince myself that a lot of people don't do that, because I've seen tweets of people being like, maybe you shouldn't have been dumb enough to send that to this person, and why would you do that? And I'm like, because I was a young girl with also an app called Snapchat that literally deletes the video after you send it. What's the harm in that? I remember hearing of this thing called SnapSave, and I was like, what the is that? And someone told me it was an app that you can download that basically whenever you open a Snapchat, it saves to your camera roll automatically. And I was like, that can't be real. Because you know how you get a notification when someone screen records or takes a screenshot? I was like, that something has to notify you.
Yeah.
I found out that existed, but I just didn't think that the person I was sending this stuff to would remotely ever think to do something like that, because this was someone I'd known my whole life. I was wrong, obviously. When I first found out that it was, I just couldn't believe it was.
The internet is forever undefeated, with every action has a reaction. But these girls would never understand. Take a look.
Would you rather make 40 grand a year working a regular job or 400 grand a year doing OnlyFans?
I would rather 400. Go back to OnlyFans than do that.
Natalie, yes. What are you picking?
400.
Okay.
I will pick the 400.
Obviously, 400K.
400K all the okay. way. If all you're right. not taking it, you're dumb.
If I do the 400K, but I put my nude body out there, that would really impact my self-esteem. I think it would make me depressed.
Amy?
I don't think money should ever cost your dignity. 40K. It's almost disrespectful to your future family as well. Did you guys see the thing about the kid who ran out of school because he was bullied about his mom's OnlyFans? Like, oh, that is God. Something that is going to continue to happen and yep. happen Ooh. And happen. Yeah. And so I think it's also out of respect to your yeah. husband and your future then family.
Money should never cost you your dignity. It's sad that the modern woman today value materialistic possessions over family life.
I know, I'm so funny, guys.
That's what men are supposed to do. They're supposed to provide for
Simps.
For women. So when a woman already has
everything.
Oh, that's when they feel intimidated.
That's when they feel intimidated.
That man isn't intimidated by a woman like you. He's annoyed by a woman like you. Because a man doesn't want to date another man. He wants to date a woman. So let's flip it so it makes sense and pay attention, right? A woman like you that's independent boss, babe, she took on characteristic traits of a man, like being non-agreeable, being assertive, and being dominant, which is all A-type personality traits, which is naturally masculine traits. So when a woman takes on that trait, it's like, ew, you're like a man now. So it's annoying. It's not intimidating. Now let's flip it. Let's say if you got with a man and he was very flamboyant and he didn't have any ambition and he was very agreeable. He was a yes man. He had no backbone. Would you feel intimidated by that man?
No.
If he was checkmate, checkmate. Wait, stop it. Stop it.
Gotcha, bitch.
Let a woman talk and she'll tell you why she's single.
Men f*** it up.
No, you know what?
Every single time! Every time!
Look, I don't think men f*** it up every single time. I think the men that you date f*** it up every single time.
Excuse
because
me?
Because you probably have a type, and the type of men that you're attracted to, those are the guys f***ing it up. There's a lot of guys out there that won't f*** it up and probably just don't give them a chance.
Ladies,
damn
just
right.
Hear me out. If it's happening every single time, maybe you're the problem.
True.
Western women are so cooked. This is why I highly recommend you guys go overseas.
You live here in Japan or are you just visiting?
I live here. You want to live in my house? You're welcome to my house.
I will come to your house.
Really?
Yes.
You're really welcome.
I want to come have dinner with you.
Not dinner. If you're coming to my home, just have dinner. No.
I'll spend a whole day with you. What's your number?
Not just one whole day. No.
She wants it.
How long?
A month.
So here I am, standing outside the house of a complete stranger in a foreign land. We just met yesterday, and now I'm about to step inside of her home.
This is pretty small home.
She seems kind, but there's a mystery about her. Who is she really? What secrets lie behind these walls? This could be the start of an unforgettable adventure, or something else entirely. My instincts are telling me to be cautious. My curiosity is pulling me forward. I've always believed in taking risks and embracing the unexpected. But this feels a little bit different.
It's just women are different.
Counter changed my life forever? Or is it a mistake I'll come to regret? What awaits me? Stay tuned to find out more.
That man pearled her harbor. She's about to give him the hibachi tour. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for today's video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe.
I'm supposed to be on a Tinder date right now, and I'm a little bit worried. So first of all, my Tinder date did not have her profile verified, which is fine. But, you know, after a little bit of talking, I messaged her and I just said, hey, do you think you could get your profile verified? And she responded just saying, nah, LOL, which, you know, I guess it's fine. I'm not gonna force someone to verify their profile. So it's whatever. We keep talking. I think, okay, there's some chemistry here. There's some flirtation. So eventually I pop the question. I just say, hey, do you want to go on a date? Maybe go for dinner, go for drinks, go for coffee. How does that sound? And she says, I have a better idea. I say, okay, what's the better idea? She says, it's a surprise. So then we switch over to text. And the day of the date comes today. And I text her. I say, okay, what's the surprise? She sends back a coordinate location and says, meet me at these coordinates at 6 p.m. This is the location. It's the middle of nowhere. And it is 5:52 right now. And I'm getting a little bit worried that my match maybe is not who she says she is.
That 15-year-old leaking videos thing, this is why you should not be doing these things, especially with boyfriends or whatever it is. I think it's a bad idea for a majority of people, at least until you get married or, you know, in a very stable relationship. When you're that young, sending nudes back and forth, it's always going to cause issues. Please subscribe below. I really appreciate it. Catch you guys next time.